They better be careful. Somebody could get their eye knocked out with one of those. Into Paul Kasmin and look at a show by Erik Parker. Well, we're sort of changing things up today because I'm going to come back for the opening later this evening, but I know at that time it'll probably be too packed to be able to see the paintings. So we're taking a little early preview here. Well, I've been watching Erik Parker's work for probably 6 or 7 years now, ever since his first show with Leo Koenig down on Lower Broadway, and I've always kind of enjoyed what he's been doing. Sort of a strange amalgamation of graffiti art, weird obsessive list making, and lowbrow illustration. This is Self-Made Man, 70 by 66. Well, I would have to say that technically Erik has tightened up the work quite a bit. It seems to be pretty drippy and splashy. He's definitely sharpened up his edges. This is Guru, probably the largest piece of the show. 99 by 90. These are all acrylic. I can see he's also punched up his colors quite a bit. New Freedom. 90 by 78. I tried to get them to tell me what the prices were on these, but they want me to talk to someone from the back office. So, I guess we'll just guess. I've always liked the way that Erik uses a little text here and there. This kind of fits in with the skate punk aesthetic of maybe somebody like a Chris Johansson as well. This is Royal. 52 by 42. Got some very nice color things going on there. An interesting feature. Erik likes to paint around the edges of the canvases here. Well, I think that's enough. We'll come back for the opening and visit the mosh pit. Well, this must be the hot ticket, man. Everybody's showing up here. There's the famous East Village art critic, Kalm.
Nervous about returning
to
Los Angeles.
Out here this evening. this always brings out a lot of the international collectors. So it's a great time to have a show and get a lot of people in to see it. These three little pieces are pretty nice. It's kind of like a psychedelic deep tangy. Starting to show up here. Ooh. Clients. Well, I guess I should have worn my baseball hat. Okay, here's Simon Cerigo. He's a professional art critic. He won't talk unless you pay him.
That's right.
He's, oh. But he's known Erik Parker for a long time.
I've known him. We used to smoke dope at Rickwitz and that show.
That was at the Rickwitz Paravanesia show.
Marijuana! Marijuana!
This was at Gavin Brown's Enterprise, what, about 10, 12 years ago?
10 years ago.
And that was where this all started. He was still going to school at Columbia?
He was still going to school.
All right,
thanks. Where's Erik? Erik, where are you? Come here. Come and verify.
Thank you, Simon Cerigo.
Okay.
Where's the website that you got your...
Artloversnewyork.com.
Artloversnewyork.com. All right.
I even have a card to prove it.
You got a card.
Yeah. Here's
Erik Parker.
Oh, hey.
Guess what? I have to apologize.
Why?
Our little interview that we did at your opening.
Huh? Did you lose it?
My battery was dead, and so I didn't get it. So now we can talk about your show.
Okay.
I did notice that your colors have really sort of bumped up and gotten a little stronger, and you really seem to be pushing the color thing. Why don't you tell us a little bit about your palette that you're using?
It's a relentless palette. Just trying to be, you know, the most extreme I can regarding color. I can't make anything soft, so I'm just not able to.
You know, I actually was into the gallery and I saw some Al Held paintings about 2 months ago, and yeah. I was thinking that some of the passages in your paintings reminded me of the Al Held with the real strong, unmodulated colors and stuff.
Yeah.
Now tell me also, you were influenced by graffiti as well.
Right.
How did that feed into your practice?
Yeah, I might pop in. I don't know. I'm really impressed. I really want to.
I don't think there's an intentional feeding in. I think it's just the way it kind of operates. There's no pre-planned drawing, or so everything's kind of spontaneous, like writing on a, maybe how it is writing on a wall. I'm not quite sure.
But it seems
like gut somewhere.
It seems like you're using less language. There was used to be a lot of words in the pieces, and now you're getting down to maybe one or two words in there. Is that because you want to become more just graphic, or is there some other thing going on with the sort of moving away from the language?
I just want it to be more graphic. Yeah.
Back more to being a pure painter.
Yeah, yes. But, I think that's it. You nailed it.
Well, okay. I know this is a little putting you on the spot, but thanks.
That's okay.
Thanks, Erik. This is James Kalm reporting on Erik Parker here at